To log out, go to the upper right-hand corner and hover your mouse over your name. The drop-down menu will appear and the second link is log out. Be sure to log out every time after you're finished. If you need help, one of the first things you can do is check out the customized user guides for ECC and Compton Center. I've put a link in the description of this video. If you're logged into OU Campus, just go to the add-ons drop-down menu up here in the top nav bar and select the user guide for your campus. Each PDF is 41 pages. Or you can always use the Omni Help site. Over here in the upper right-hand corner, there is a help button and a drop-down menu with four links. What we want is this first link, Support, which takes you to the OU Campus version 10 support site. By the way, if you click on the help button itself, you're taken to the same place. You'll notice it opens up in a new tab, so you don't have to worry about losing your place back in OU Campus. But just as an FYI, the system will time out. So if you spend a long time here on the support site and then try to get back into OU Campus, you might find that you've been automatically logged out, so be sure to save your work. I recommend viewing the support site in Chrome or Firefox because part of it gets cut off if you're using Internet Explorer, like this. So I'll just switch to Chrome really quick. Okay, so there's a whole lot going on here, and a lot of this info isn't really relevant for end users. So where are the parts on this page where you can find the help that you need? Let's go from left to right. Basically, don't worry about all these links on the left. What we want is up here in this top nav bar and on the right in these quick links. Some of the pages we'll jump to are places you could have eventually gotten to by drilling down with this left nav bar, but it's a lot faster to do it via the top nav bar or the quick links. Okay, top nav bar. If you hover over the phrase end user, you see the following links that might be helpful. I'm going to read them out loud for 508 compliance. Logging in, creating a new page, checking in and out content, using the WYSIWYG editor, editing an image. Don't worry about creating assets. That's not relevant to you as a level 7 user. Publishing a page and the PDF of the end user's reference guide. Next to the phrase end user, we have administrators, which doesn't apply, and then we have training. If you hover over training, it brings up another helpful drop-down menu. You can check out Omni's Training Tuesday's webinars, go through Omni's LMS, which stands for Learning Management System, watch some videos, look at their PDF guides, and go through the glossary. Next to that is support. If you hover over it, the link in the drop-down menu that you want is troubleshooting. Here they have a list of FAQs that look very helpful. Now for the quick links on the right. These are for downloading the PDFs of the various reference guides. The only ones you'll need are these first two, End Users and End User Short, and this sixth one down, the Quick Reference Guide. Just FYI, the End Users Guide is very thorough at 183 pages. The short version is 91 pages, and the Quick Reference Guide is 5 pages. If you're looking for something more in the middle, don't forget the customized El Camino or Compton Center user guides mentioned at the beginning of this video. Those are only 41 pages. And then, of course, there's the search box where you can type in the search term of what you need help with.